Mr. Walter Fust, Mr. Victor Bodo, Mr. Tariq Ahmad Karim, Mr. Shankar Agarwal, Mr. M.B. Narayanan, Mr. Ravi Gupta, officers from the Department of Information Technology, Government of India, other government officers, distinguished delegates from all over the world participating in this very important international dialogue, other invitees. First of all, let me congratulate the organizers for arranging an event of this kind. Accelerating the pace of developmental interventions with the help of ICT, that is the overall theme of this conference. When we talk about accelerating the pace of development, developmental interventions, we have to think about quality services, transparency, and accountability. How information and communication technology can very well address these issues, that is the challenge before each and every one of us. And when it comes to the two themes of this conference, e-governance and e-health, it is embracing all the 8 millennium developmental goals. We all know that in 2189 nations signed an undertaking that we will address 8 millennium developmental goals by 2015. I think we are in 2011, and technology there is no need of repeating the Millennium Developmental Goals. You can see that all these ICT interventions, whether it be from our country, India, whether it be from Bangladesh, whether it is Moldova, or any country for that matter, these are all addressing these particular issues. First and foremost, we are all aware of the importance of eradicating extreme poverty and hunger. We may ask, what is the role of information and communication technology? Just look at the food distribution system. We are talking about ration card distributions. These are all, the quality of such services are going to be definitely enhanced. We see the results. We have many of these things in plenty. But when it comes to distribution, when it comes to last citizen and delivery, probably things are getting diluted, things are getting diffused rather. And therein comes the importance of information and communication technology. And the Government of India's contributions, Government of India's interventions in this area is very, very, very prominent. For example, whether it be the government to citizen services which are happening through a collaboration with the government systems and the private initiatives under the public-private participation mode through the credible civil society organizations in this country, a lot of things are happening. Similarly, achieving universal primary education, that is the second millennium developmental goals. Several countries have come up with Right to Education Act. Of course, we are also progressing very fast in this area, but unless and until contextualized information and communication technology is applied, we will not be able to achieve this thing. And with the advent of broadband, with the advent of cloud computing, and with the advent of mobile revolution, I think in these areas, things can be improved. And the third Millennium Development Goal is again gender equality and empowerment of women. We know the activities happening particularly in African countries under the leadership of Wangari Maathai and all that, how women empowerment, how women in agriculture, how information and communication technology is addressing these issues. Government as well as several organizations are collaborating with such activities. And when it comes to child mortality, it is very important our Additional Secretary Mr. Shankar Agarwal was mentioning about the Right to Food Act, which is going to come here. The nutrition security interventions which a country of this kind is undertaking. and the role of nutrition is very, very important. And when it comes to the development as a whole, for any developing country, or we can see that if we concentrate on nutrition and basic education, the rest of the things will come automatically. Any society or any country which has concentrated on nutrition and basic education, these societies or these countries have advanced significantly, the rest of the things will come automatically. And improving maternal health. This is also a major issue which is challenging, particularly highly populated developing countries. And importance of technology in health awareness, importance of technology in medical interventions, these are all very effectively happening. And it is very important that unconventional networking with the government, public sector, private sector, and civil society organization should happen to achieve the targets. And combating HIV/AIDS, malaria, and other diseases. Therein also comes the importance of e-health interventions. And environmental sustainability, for example, we talk about the climate change, green IT, and green almost as a suffix for any intervention which we have any. This is really affecting, this is the real issue which we face in all developmental interventions, and the role of information and communication technology is again very, very significant in this area. And the eighth goal is nothing but the global partnership for development. Understanding how success stories have developed within countries, as well as across the globe in different countries, how these success stories can be effectively contextualized and applied to different nations. And now there is no the physical barriers have almost disappeared, and information and communication technology can do a great deal in these areas. If you just look at the intervention, the collaborative involvement of the civil and the credible civil society organizations in the area of information and communication technology, education, and the two departments, two ministries of the government of India, Ministry of IT and Ministry of HRD, you can see how much synergies we are trying to develop. And this could be possible for any interventions. For example, with the infrastructure department and the National Knowledge Network, providing broadband connectivity to all educational institutions is coming here. It is almost all the universities have availed this. Now all the colleges are also going to get the NKN connectivity. Similarly, with the Ministry of HRD, there is a National Mission of Education through ICT providing broadband connectivity to all colleges and all that. And then with the Ministry of IT under the National E-Governance Plan, the very ambitious, probably in scale and in quality, unparalleled in the country, the Common Service Centers program, providing information and communication technology capability to 600,000 villages in this country. And these centers can also function as various other units for providing to the ordinary people awareness and also knowing about their entitlement. If we make our citizens, every citizen, know their entitlement, the empowerment will automatically happen. And information and communication technology has a great to do to make people aware of their entitlement, whether it be the entitlement of land, whether it be entitlement of education, whether it be entitlement of food. And this is something very important, and upscaling is the real challenge of countries, highly populated developing countries. Upscaling can happen only with technology intervention. And when technology interventions happens, we should also ensure that quality is there. And by these processes, by involving international partners, as well as the government, several government departments, I am confident that we will be able to achieve the much desired millennium developmental goals, maybe in a much more faster way. And let me wish this program all success. Let me once again thank and appreciate the efforts taken by the organizers in this event.